now are here to share some of their favorite stories with you. So give it up for Alex Vincent and Christine Elise. How are you guys doing?
I requested the warm room.
How's you guys, besides being ha ha ha, how's the day going for you guys?
It's going great.
It's going great. It's my first time in Sacramento.
Welcome.
Thank you.
It's a good city, man.
I live in Florida.
Oh, there you go. You're used to
strong.
But you guys, the Chucky franchise has been one of those ones that we were so excited to have you guys for this one, because it felt like one of the franchises that at Sinister we haven't gotten to dive in to yet. And Chucky is, of course, an icon. And your guys' battle with him throughout the franchise, throughout the series, has become just, without question, the most fun to watch. And I would say the majority of horror franchises that are still around. So right off the get-go, let me just say thank you for coming back again and doing what you guys did for that show. But we were talking before you guys got here. The reason why the original scared the hell out of me was because Chucky is based on my buddy. And that doll scared the shit out of me when my parents gave it to me. And then came Chucky. But you, Alex, come into the franchise as a six-year-old kid. Like, did the premise freak you out at all? Like, any of the puppeteering or anything?
No, I knew of my buddy dolls back then, too. This was just a more expensive my buddy that was operated by seven puppeteers. Being on set was very fun, cool. For a six-year-old boy, it's like a pretty awesome toy to play with.
And we fast forward, mom's in the mental hospital, and Andy is on to the next chapter of his life, which brings us to Child's Play 2, where you guys inevitably crossed paths. What was it like for you back then to come into the franchise and get
to the part? It was awesome. I mean, I'm an actress, but I pay my rent by being an actress, you know, so any job is exciting, even jobs that are projects like, you know, Father to Ellen Industries or Matlock, and things I'm not necessarily a fan of, but that's how I make my living, you know? So to get a job as cool as Child's Play 2 and work for as many weeks as we did, like 7 weeks on that four. And it was really, really exciting.
This premise is not one that was seen all the time, or it was not done to death at the time of them coming out. So what was it like for you, Alex, as a young kid, to know that you're battling the killer doll, Chucky? You have Brad there, I would imagine.
Brad was really never there.
I mean,
when we made the first film, I got to meet him before we ever did a day of shooting. He was there for maybe a week in Chicago before we actually started. Brad was there and did a little rehearsing kind of things with him there. But after that, he recorded all of the stuff in the studio separate.
So when you're on set, I guess that for one and two, he is doing his lines in the studio. Who was it that was?
No, it was him on playback.
Oh, okay, so he's doing
it. He did it first.
I got you.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
So you had to lead Chucky to pull your emotion.
Yeah, I mean, I'm a sound guy myself, so seeing reverse engineered ADR was kind of cool. First of all, his voice was there, and they made the doll work around that voice. And it's always easier working off Brad's voice than some script supervisor. You know, I'm going to kill you, man.
Yeah, for sure.
It was always fun. I mean, the challenge of there's so many moments when you're an actor that you're doing a scene, looking at a piece of tape or like an eye line on the other side of the camera. The actor's not even there. So the inanimate element of the doll, kind of acting as acting sort of. But having a voice on set is definitely helpful.
Was it the same way as ADR first,
so
you got to hear him?
Yeah, I got to meet him and I rehearsed all of our dialogue so he would know what I was going to do before he recorded what he was doing. So, and I was already a huge fan of his, and so I was completely starstruck. That was one of the most exciting things about getting a job, was getting to meet Brett DeRoe. My experience on two was that he was 8 years old and controlled by child labor laws, and puppeteers were all union actors, as 7 or 9 of them. So they were more expensive to have on set than I was, because there's so many more of them. So what they would do is, if you don't, like, they'd shoot the big wide establishing of the scene, they'd take a scene, then they would shoot Alex out so they could get him off the clock, maybe he's a little tutor, or things that kids do on set. And then they shoot the puppet, and then send the puppeteers home. So I did a whole bunch of stuff in that movie to nothing, to like you said, tape on a camera stand, you know? The red tape is Chucky, the blue tape is Alex, go, you know? So it's that's challenging when it's literally nothing fucking there. But I learned as it went on to try to keep myself as physically close to Alex as possible so they couldn't shoot me without him. So, but if you see him on camera and the other people aren't there, they probably won't go on set either, so.
Your guys' evolution in the franchise, like, we saw you guys go from scary kids to these, like, hardened, Chucky torturing badasses that are on the road hunting down all your Chuckies. So what was it like to get to come back to the franchise and put that spin on your character?
Well, first, I'd like to say I think Kyle was pretty badass from the start.
Yeah.
You are, I think you still have this record that you're up, at least as of a little while ago, you're up the one girl that wiped him out completely, like the one actress that actually kicked his ass, like Fiona. Beat him up quite a bit. There was, I'm not doing a specific statistic justice, but there is something about you too that, like, you wipe him out and no other actresses have done that or something like that.
That's not true.
Didn't Catherine Hicks
start? Yeah, Catherine Hicks is the one who finished him off with a shot to the heart in the first film.
That's true, yeah.
And, but so, a woman killed him in the first film, and a woman killed him in the second film. Tiffany's killed him a few times. I usually set him up for the kill. But luckily I got to come back and, you know, not just kill him, but have a little fun with him first.
Well, yeah, so with that, with you having the Chucky head in your...
Which Kyle also killed.
Yeah.
I'm like, thank you for taking care of him.
It's not you.
Whole premise of how you develop is we get to see, like, you're talking about you guys pretend to not just Chucky, but now we've gone and you've gotten, like, Buff Chucky and Nice Chucky, and
there's no such thing as good Chucky.
So what was that like to have Chucky still as Brad? Brad still doing the line, which was super important, like, and you guys coming back, and it's like you're along the ride, but we're seeing the passing of the torch to the new kids with Jake and history of battling Chucky. It is kind of cool to see that we have, like, the old meets new component on the show.
Yeah, I mean, I think we've been telling this story for 36 years, so it's gone through a lot of different incarnations, different tones, different feelings, different actors, different characters. But the joy of it for us is we're really a Chucky family. We say it
give it to, and then I thought about that. Like, maybe we've actually worked on these things so many years ago, and they're bonded together. But the same goes for us, and I guess anyone involved in a franchise. So, passing the torch, working with people again, any way you look at it, it's a bonding experience, and it's important to all of us.
And Don Mancini is a really sentimental guy, and he gets really attached to people. So he has good taste for people too. I think all the kids in the show are so raised right kids. They're all really smart. They're all really sweet. And so yeah, you do think the bond is there. The bond is very real, especially with us two. He's like, I always say, my brother from another mother. I talk to Alex almost every day. So it's, what you see on screen is true.
You guys, on set, because this seems like the perfect playground to do this. We had CJ Graham up here earlier, and he was saying on that Friday the 13th set that he was scared the hell out of people. So, is there any, like, behind the scenes?
That was the puppeteer's job. They did a little bit of that, messing with people. Not as much as they could have, but they did a little bit. Yeah.
It's a big show. It's a big show. There's no time to fucking around, really. You know, it's an expensive show, and it's a job, and you know, it's a job.
How about that in 1 and 2? Was there any other shenanigans?
That's what I was talking about. The show, I agree with Christine, it's so many moving parts, and the schedule was really kind of tight, and you know, the show's 8 episodes. We made about 90 minutes of Chucky every 7 years or something for a while, and now we're making 8 hours in 4 months. So yeah, there's a lot of moving parts and a lot of people working hard all at once. So yeah, the shenanigans were limited there. In fact, with Kevin Yeager's crew in part 1 and part 2,
there's a picture on my table of me in the car singing Child's Play 2, and it's me leaning over to give Chucky a kiss as he's leaning in to take the kiss. And it happened because in between takes, the puppeteers can make him do anything they want, and they were making him feel my leg and flirt with me. And so, oh, we want a piece of this, and I leaned in to give him a kiss. It's a really great, one of my favorite photos. He's leaning in to get the kiss. I made him let me repeat that with the head and called the Chucky, so I recreated that shot. I have that on the table too, but that's about as far as it goes. It's not like, it's still a job, you know, sure.
I don't know, they send them to my trailer every night. I don't know, that's, I don't know.
My last question for you guys is, where do you want to see Chucky go next?
To season 4.
Yeah.
Hashtag
#Reunite. Hashtag, you guys don't have a good chance with these guys. Like, hashtag #Reunite Chucky is definitely a thing.
It is.
And you guys, you know, it trends, you know, almost immediately after the season ends, the hashtag #Reunite Chucky movement has really become a thing online with this fandom. So it lets you guys know, I'm sure, that the fandom very much loves you guys. Absolutely.
There was a phone number you called too. Did you call it? So you call his phone number.
No, I didn't want them to know that I called him.
I did call it. And then you get texts of Chucky fucking heckling you and shit. It was cool. It was really fun.
Yeah.
It didn't go on long enough, I don't think. We should have kept it going.
Well, we've seen him now in Catholic Reform School. We've seen him in the White House. Like, we did this on our page, we've had been running the Twitter polls, and like, outer space won.
No, come on.
Time travel.
Jason, his old Jason.
Like time travel.
Time travel.
I like that idea. Especially since, like, Back to the Future was filmed on the same lot as us when we made Child's Play 2. And Don took me to go see Back to the Future. Actually, they were filming 3 here just now. So there's a little good reason for that. Chucky time travel.
So if he does it, are you going Back to the Future rules? Is he going to have the color in with Andy? Nanny's disappearing when he wins?
I don't know. Wait a minute. Does this mean some kid plays my role?
Yeah.
I'll do that.
How about you? Anywhere that you would want to see?
No, I just trust Don Mancini. I thought the White House was biting off more than like a taken a big risky bite, and I was wrong. It was fucking great.
Yeah.
I thought season 3 was really awesome. So, yeah, whatever. Don is a genius.
Guys, who has a question for Christine Hines? Let's go right here in the front row.
Not some sock along or something. And he did, so.
It's shot of you guys that shot.
The Blue Dog Saints shot?
Yes, like, you came back to battle. So.
Yeah, yeah, we did.
We're family.
Yeah.
I know you're busy with Chucky right now, with the series and everything, but do you ever work with, like, independent filmmakers, like fan films? Do you ever do, like, couple projects like that?
I can't do fan films because it's not, they tend not to be union.
Yeah, that's not,
so I can't do a little project.
Yeah.
And honestly, I've done a lot of independent films for friends, you know, that I know them, and it's a fun experience. You've got 7 people in a crew, and you're making $100 a day. But that's, you need to really trust somebody and have a track record with them to put yourself in that situation, because movie making is really a lot more complicated than you guess. You could end up in a really bad situation where someone doesn't know what they're doing, you know? There's a lot of independent stuff on my resume, though.
I know that you guys are dealing with a lot just last year, where you had to go to the picket lines and try to fight for, you know, digital and everything to make sure that they don't overstep.
And AI.
Yeah.
Yeah. I don't think you got a very good deal, but I think it's kind of still that getting fucked over, but we tried.
Yeah.
This
dude
over there.
Yes. Stand up?
Yeah, like, shout.
I was going to ask if you guys were, like, actually in conflict with 19, and what you guys were doing.
Oh,
no.
The other movie?
We've not seen it.
It's terrible.
Wow.
But you can Google my name and Chucky remake, Chucky, and you'll see a lot of headlines like Christine Elise loses her fucking mind over the reboot. Because I said to a podcast guy that I thought it was a dick move and bullshit that they were trying to fuck with Donnie and Sammy's intellectual property. And every headline got more and more dramatic, and I was fucking unhinged about the thing. And then not took me to dinner for being a dick.
I should try that.
Anybody else? Yeah.
Okay, so in season 2, like, Kyle and Andy's last scene really felt like they were riding off into the sunset, and that, like, image from the movie came up. So, like, obviously you want to keep working, but were you kind of surprised that there was more to Kyle and Andy's story after that? Like, no, you knew. Because it really felt like a closure.
It did. And people got choked up and stuff. The old footage was really used to great effect, you know?
Well, that is the last time we've seen those characters.
No, well, you
know,
that was
a dream.
Well, we wanted some more.
Yeah, me too. And I was supposed to be in season 3, and it just didn't. The story just changed in a way that didn't involve me. If it's a season 4, you know, fingers crossed, some of us will be there. If we're not dead, I can't imagine we're going away.
Right.
You know?
We always come back.
Well, thank you guys.
Oh, that's his line.
I was waiting for you guys to show up when shit hit the fan and the CIA guy with the mustache was harassing the president's wife, was really taking it over. I'm like, where are they?
You know, Don said to me, he's like, I can't have Kyle just come in at the last minute and save the day again. She's done that like 3 times. And so, I can't just keep doing that same thing, you know? But wait a minute, here comes Kyle, you know?
I mean, I will be fucking doing it. That's a pretty running hit, like, hey.
Yeah.
Right when it's at the brink of disaster, here you come.
I guess predictable.
I've heard some of Don's thoughts for season 4, and it just makes me all the more passionate about my desire to see the season happen. So, fingers crossed in the beginning.
Yeah. Anybody else? Maybe shy?
What projects are you personally most proud of? Like, it could be within the franchise or, like, out of the franchise.
I did a commercial for Hardy's Town Puppies. I think it's all been downhill from that. For me, it's Andy's. I mean, no question.
I did a TV show in the 80s about Vietnam called China Beach, and I gave some really great stuff to do on that show. And I did ER for a year too, and that one. They're both run by the same people. China Beach and ER are the same people. So it's doing really well written, and the actors they hire are so talented that the job is so easy because the words are there, and the other actors are so talented, they're doing the work for you. So I sort of achieve things myself that I didn't think I had in me. So those jobs are good for me.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Yes.
Thanks, guys.
Thank you. Bye.